excellent and safe at home. Today we'll start one new lesson, that is from Behind, lesson number 4, A Truly Beautiful Mind. A truly beautiful mind, about a great personality, great scientist, you know, Nobel Prize winner, Albert Einstein. So, the characters, only two characters are there in this lesson, that is Albert Einstein and his wife, that is Mileva Marek. Today, we will see the short summary, the chapter sketch of this lesson. Very, you know, very beautiful lesson. Very inspiration. We get inspiration, inspirational, you know, we get the inspiration from this lesson. Many people got inspiration from this, and many people will get here afterwards. I like this lesson very much. So, the main, what is the theme? What is the character, chapter sketch of this lesson? This one thing is, you know, the theme of the story. The theme of the story is, see, the great men are not born with a special science. In their childhood days, they are also like common children, and their likes and dislikes are very much similar to them, similar to common people, common children. Their parents also take care of them as normally parents do. Childhood, understand? And generally, these children develop some specific virtues and become a great when they grow. Here, the theme of the story is that, what is the chapter sketch of this? See, this story recounts the life of an outstanding scientific personality, Albert Einstein. From his birth to his death, his theories totally changed our understanding of space and time. His theory, that the relativity of, you know, that's the theory, changed everything. Though he was not successful in his married life, his scientific exploits won him the Nobel Prize for Physics in 1921. He was known as a visionary and the world citizen. Visionary and a world citizen as much as a scientific genius. What is this? The world, Albert Einstein, known as a visionary. Visionary, those who sees the vision. About the, think about the future. So he thought about the future and world citizen. World citizen to good all the things for people. This is the character sketch. So we'll see the theme, life, what about the Einstein. What's Einstein's early life of Einstein? Early life of Einstein is, Albert Einstein was born in, born to German parents and on 14th March 1879 in Germany. His mother thought that he was abnormal because his head was too big compared to other children. So she thought that he is an abnormal child. And that also, and he started speaking at the age of, you know, 2.5 with very difficulty. Normally, children speak at the age of 1 year or 1.5. This Einstein started speaking at the age of 2.5, with very difficulty. And when he started speaking, he was uttering each word twice. That is also was there. And compared to the other, he started speaking that also with very difficulty. And he loved. What he loved? He loved to play with the mechanical toys. You know the mechanical toys? And he always played in alone. No friends. friends, nothing. And with the mechanical toys, he liked that toys, preferred to play alone. Thus, the other children called him Brother Bore. You know, bore. What will you do? What? Yeah, bore karta hai yaar ye. So, this way, because he liked always to play with the mechanical toys and he always played alone. So, other friend circles and all his friend circles said, used to say him, called him Brother Bore. Even his school headmaster was not happy. His school headmaster was not happy with his, the attitude and all. Once he called his father and said, whichever field you will give, and Albert, he will not success in any field. Your child will not success in any field. And whatever career he took up, his mother made him learn how to play violin at the age of 6. You know, mothers are always mother. They love their children very much. So, she taught that child, Albert, how to play violin. And at the age of 6, he later on became a talented amateur, not professional. Means he was playing the violin for his entertainment. And a violinist, those who play the violin very perfectly, so we call that a violinist. See, his early life was like that. Then what about his education and married life? Then the education and married life, when Einstein's parents shifted to other city, they allowed him to continue the school in Munich. So they continued him in the school in the Munich. After that, what happened, you know, high school at the age of, but he left the high school. He got admission in Munich, here in Munich, and after that, at the age of 15, he left the school. You know, at the age of 15, in which class the children are always there, you know, like you, 15, 16, or 9, 10, like this, you know, in this classes. So at the age of 15, he left that school. Why? Because that management of that school was so strict. He couldn't fix, you know, manage over there. So he left the school. And usually, he was extraordinary. We are talking about his education. You know, we are talking about his education. He was extraordinary. He was interested in subject physics. And he was so clever. Albert Einstein was a very genius personality. You know, clever, scholar, genius, you know, the step by step. Once we say that, he's a very clever boy. Okay, clever. He's a very scholar boy. And the genius, the extraordinary. You know, those who do something extra is called a genius. Then he was, his favorite subject was mathematics. And, but he was interested in physics. And after that, he has taken, after the 15 years, he left the school, taken admission in university and university in Zurich. There he met a Serbian girl, Meliva Marin. When he has taken admission in the university, there he met a girl, that Serbian girl, Meliva Marin, who was also an intellectual personality. They fell in love. They fell in love, ultimately married with each other. Albert found a job in the finishing of his university. After completing his studies, after the completing of studies in the university, he got a job. And, but you know, they got married. This Albert Einstein and Meliva were married. They fell in love and they got married. And they, but after few years, you know, after the 16 years of their married life, that family was not satisfied, so they divorced each other, you know, they have taken divorce and they had two sons. even though he was very successful in his life, but his married life was not successful. And after that, he married with his cousin in the same year. Okay, and what is, you know, the Nobel Prize winner? He is a Nobel Prize winner because what is the Nobel Prize winner? What he has done, you know, the Nobel Prize winner that Einstein published his general theory of relativity in 1915, which is that Einstein published his general theory of relativity in 1915. The newspaper proclaimed his work as a scientific revolution. Which revolution was that? He received the Nobel Prize for the physics in 1921 and was lauded by everyone, praise and on everyone. Then what is that his relativity was, theory of relativity? Einstein finally secured a job and then he has completed side by side. He continued developing his own ideas. He published his special theory, that is very important, that is in 1905, according to which time and distance. Time and distance are not absolute, okay? And he obtained the world famous formula that is describing the relationship between mass and energy, that is E is equal to mc square. That is E is equal to mc square. That is the famous formula. Nowadays, in all our science education, we are using this formula. And in 1915, Einstein published his general theory of relativity. The solar eclipse of the sun proved his theory, that is correct. He became a famous as his work was considered a scientific revolution. Then what happened? What is the other next thing? Immigration to US. Then he shifted to US. US. Immigration. Einstein emerged to the US in 1913 when the Nazis came to a power in Germany. You know Nazis? Nazis, a ruling party, it was ruling party in Germany. Like in our India, now which is the ruling party? Yes, the Bharatiya Janata Party is the ruling party. The those days in the 1933 when Einstein was too young, that time Nazis was there, the ruling party. Then 5 years later, the discovery of nuclear fission in Berlin had an American physicist in an uproar. Many of them fled. You know, when Nazis was there, many scientists fled away. They left that place and ran away from there, as Einstein had, and they were afraid that Nazis could, this ruling party could build and use atomic bomb. And really, what happened? Then he has written, then he got the Nobel Prize. Just now we have said the immigration, he shifted to him because the ruling party of Nazis, the in German. Then he, the Albert Einstein, wrote a letter to a president. Albert Einstein wrote a letter to president. What Einstein wrote a letter to Franklin D. Roosevelt. Who was the president? Franklin D. Roosevelt, the American president, and warned him that a single nuclear bomb would make a mass destruction. A single unit bomb would make a mass destruction. So, but the American secretly developed, they did not listen. He had written a letter, but they did not listen. It was no effect of his letter. But the American secretly developed that, an atomic bomb, and dropped it on Japan, that is the cities of Hiroshima and Nagasaki. After this, he felt very sad, you know. Einstein sorrow. What is the Einstein sorrow? Einstein ka dukh kya tha? Then, what was his sorrow? When they dropped that bomb on Japan, the cities of Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Then Einstein was deeply shaken by the destruction caused by the atomic bomb. He proposed to the United Nations for forming a world government. After that, he wrote an open letter, letter to the president there and to forming a world government. But this letter was given no impact. Over the next decade, he got involved in politics for and the end of arms buildup and campaign for the peace and democracy. He was very absent. But that letter was also no impact on them. Then he campaigned for the war and continued campaign for an end to arms buildup and used the popularity to campaign for peace and democracy. Peace and democracy. And in 1955, till his day, Einstein's death, he died in the year 1955. He was known as a celebrated visionary and a world citizen as much as the scientific genius. So this is the completely, the summary, the theme, what he has done in this. Dear children, we can take inspiration from this lesson. How he was when he was childhood and how he has, developed his career in education, and he became a Nobel Prize winner. So here we have seen his early life and the education and the married life. He got Nobel Prize in 1921 immigration. Then after completing his education, he shifted to US. And then after, when he come to know that they are making bomb, so he had written a letter to US president, but it was no impact, Then after, when they dropped the bomb, he was deeply sorrowed, and then he engaged himself, campaign for himself, for the world peace and democracy and the world peace. His great personality died in 1955, and everyone knows that the visionary, he celebrated as a visionary and a world citizen as much as the scientific genius. I hope you understood this lesson, dear children. Thank you, and have a nice day.